Hello friends, here in this video we are going to see the definition of fracture and the different modes or types of fracture. Let us get started with the definition part. Fracture. It is defined as the breaking of material under load into two or more pieces. So, fracture, it is defined as the breaking of a material under load into two or more pieces. Then, fracture means the failure of a material. Next, fracture, it starts from internal irregularities of a material such as, that is, fracture is caused because of some internal irregularities such as internal holes present inside the material, cavities or cracks. So fracture will start from internally, where there is a small hole inside the material. If there is some cracks present or there are some cavities inside the material. Next, fracture starts from within the material and then reaches up to the surface. So fracture will start from inside the material and then it reaches up to the surface. Now once we have understood the definition, now I can start with the modes of fracture. In the modes of fracture, I'll write down, there are basically two modes of fracture and they are ductile fracture and second, brittle fracture. Now, to understand these modes in detail, here I'll write down the first one, that is ductile fracture. Now for ductile fracture, here if we consider an element, or I can say a rod, which is stressed. Here we have a rod. This is the axis of the rod. Now if we apply tensile load over this rod, if we are trying to pull the rod by applying tensile load, then what will happen is, I'll draw the different modes. First of all, the diameter, it will slightly decrease. Under the action of the load, the diameter will start decreasing. If there are internal holes present, then the crack will go on forming and this diameter will be further reduced when the load value increases. So in the next stage, more number of holes will appear inside the material, or if there are more number of holes, there would be cracks developed. Next, finally, the diameter will be reduced to a very small value. Here this region, it is called as the neck, which is formed, that is the diameter has reduced to a minimum value. And after this stage, the cracks would be formed and finally when we increase the load value, then the material will break. And the material will break into this form. And here, this arrangement, this is called as cup, and here we have cone arrangement. That is, once we have applied the load, the length will go on increasing, diameter will go on decreasing, and then if there is internal holes, because of that the stress will go on increasing. Again, when the load is applied or load is increased, the diameter will go on decreasing. Finally, there will be a neck formed that is a very small diameter, and again if we are applying the load, then the material will break into two halves, and here we have cup and cone arrangement. So this was regarding the ductile fracture. Next, I can draw a graph related to this. Stress versus strain graph. Now, here we have point O to A, then B, C, D, E and F, where F is called as the breaking point. Now, once we are increasing the stress value, strain increases. 0 to A is called as elastic limit. Next, A to B, here we have another region in which if we are applying the load, and then when the load is removed, material will go back to its original shape. So here after this we have A to B. Again, this is an elastic region. Next, C is called as upper yield point, and D is called as lower yield point. Then point E, it is called as the yield point or maximum stress point, and finally point F, it is called as the breaking point, where the material will break into two parts. So when a material, one, a material is subjected to ductile fracture, it will follow the above graph which I have drawn here. So now here we have seen that when a material is subjected to ductile fracture, it will follow the above graph. That is, the material will follow this nature, where we are getting at point E the stress value as maximum, and if the material reaches maximum stress value, then even if the stress decreases, there is a point at which the material will finally break, called as the breaking point. So this was for ductile material. Now let us see the brittle fracture. Now for brittle fracture, let us consider a material which is brittle. This is the axis of that brittle material. Now let this material be wood, because we know that wood is a brittle material, and let this wood be subjected to load as shown in figure. This is a tensile load. Now what will happen is, when wood is subjected to tensile load, first of all it won't show any physical deformation. That is the property of brittle materials, that at first when the load is applied and the load is going on increasing, the material will not show any physical change. But suddenly after some time, what may happen is, when the load increases, the material will break suddenly, and that will result in its failure. So here I can say that in case of brittle fracture of materials, when the load is applied material will not show any physical change in shape at first. So when the load is applied, the material won't show any change of shape at first, or we can say initially, but after some time it will break suddenly due to internal cracks reaching up to the surface. So in case of brittle materials, they are not as easily they will flow as compared to the ductile materials previously, which we have seen. In case of ductile materials, the shape change was visible, that the diameter was going on reducing, it was visible, and finally it failed. But in case of brittle materials, the material, without any giving any prior warning, it can break at any given instant. So I have draw the graph for brittle material as well. Stress versus strain graph for brittle material. Here we directly have a breaking point, that is the material will break directly without any giving any prior warning, and the value of stress, it is called as ultimate stress, that is the stress at which the material breaks. So brittle materials follow the graph alongside as I have drawn here, and stress at breaking point is maximum and called as ultimate stress. So to avoid failure due to fracture, materials must be stressed below maximum stress value. That is, we should operate the material below the maximum stress, and then only, because ultimate stress is the maximum stress, we need to operate the material below this maximum stress, then only the material won't be failing because of fracture. So in this video, we have seen the different modes of fracture along with the definition.